This is NKTech. I'll be showing you how you can make a 200 watts inverter circuit based on the NE55 timer IC and just two core BJTs, TIP142 and TIP147. One is NPN and the other one is PNP. They are complementaries of each other. So for the control signal, the NE55 timer is connected in a stable mode whereby the output frequency is determined by the value of the capacitors, by this capacitor, Hemi capacitor. In this case, it's 50 nanofarads. There is this Hemi resistor R1, 100 kilo ohms, and this other resistor, 4.7 kilo ohms. So this ensures that the duty cycle is about 50% for both high and low signals. So the output frequency is determined by the formula 1.44, or that divided by the value of R1, which is 4.7 kilo ohms, plus 2R1, which is 100 kilo ohms, all that multiplied by the value of this capacitor C1. So pin 2 is the trigger pin, is connected to this capacitor as shown here, as well as to pin 6. Pin 7 is the discharge pin. So basically, when this capacitor is charging, when current flows from the VCC to here, the output is high, and so when the voltage of this capacitor gets to that VCC, the internal BJT will be turned on and the discharge P7 will discharge the capacitor to ground. So when the capacitor is discharging, it means that the output will be low. So pin 4 and 8 are connected to the positive rail, pin 5 to ground via this capacitor, it's 10 nanofarads, and this is the ground pin, pin 1. So the output is pin 3, whereby the square wave passes are generated. So when pin 3 is high, this NPN transistor will conduct and it will allow current to flow through the transistor, through this series capacitor, through the primary winding and to ground as shown here. So when pin 3 turns low, it means that this NPN transistor will turn off, but since this PNP transistor is its complementary, it will turn on. This means that current will flow through the negative side of the power supply, through the primary winding, through the capacitor into ground. So if you look at it, it's a half bridge inverter as shown here. So it means that it can operate at 100% duty cycle easily since the transformer is reset in each half cycle. And so to obtain more power, you can parallel more of these transistors to increase the current carrying capacity as shown. So for the transformer, you can use a transformer with a transformation ratio of 1:20 if you want a 12-240 output inverter, or 1:10 if you want a 12-120 volts output. The output frequency can be controlled by adjusting the values of either of these three components, but the one which you can easily vary is C1. So basically that's all about it, but ensure that the batteries use one with a high capacity, otherwise they die pretty quickly. So that's all about this inverter circuit. Don't forget to like below, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel for more amazing projects and tutorials.